So it's the only dark color zip I had, and momentarily I just went and lost it. Okay, so what we're doing is we've changed the foot on the machine, and we're going to start attaching this on. So the only difficult part on attaching this zip is figuring out the right way to do this. Okay, so this is the one side, and we're going to attach this from the one side. So placing your right side of the zip down on top of the fabric, start from the shoulder area, and we're going to attach this on the open. The fabric is just open, and let the machine thing guide itself. The groove actually opens up as you're going down, and the foot part should just, you should just let it guide itself along the side, and it opens along and then it curls back up. So you have to do this with the zip open. Okay, and that basically, when it curls up, this is what it should look like. It should curl back up to cover the zip up. So open the zip back up, and we're going to be going along to the other side of the dress. Again, if you look at this dress, this is the confusing, most confusing part of this zip is attaching. Now this time around you are sewing toward the opposite side, but again starting at the top, and this time the zip piece is actually towards the opposite side towards you. So before it was facing, the fabric was on the left hand side, this time the fabric is on the right hand side, and you are sewing towards the right hand side closest to the edge. Keep the same kind of distance and sew on a similar kind of about just before an inch or 2 inches before the seaming finishes. Okay, so if you were to try at the moment, both the zip sides are attached, and if you close this up, what you should have is the center of this dress joined up, whereas the sides and all of the rest of the dress is still open. And after trialing lots and lots of different methods, I found this to be the easiest. So what we're going to do is now we're going to stitch the bottom and also stitch a small amount of the top as well. So I'm going to change the foot back to, I'm going to change the foot onto not the normal foot, but the one-sided, either the dory type foot or the zip foot. And this attachment where I've gone and done the zip, I'm going to open the zip up, and opening up both of these seams, I'm just gonna stitch along. Trying to find. Right, okay. I'm going to sketch along and close this top portion of the dress off fairly close to where the zip has been attached. And also to the point where I want to close this zip off. So again, open my seams up, fold the zip over towards the outer side, and guiding myself, I'm just gonna push the zip towards the inside and really just close this seam off all the way down to the hem of the dress. Open this up, this is just one side of the dress stitched up. That basically is the zip, invisible zip attached in the center, as you can see, and we can press this flat open, all the seam going all the way down to the hemline. This is the center of the rest of the dress is still open, one side of the dress. I'm going to be doing the neckline here. Now I'm going to do the shoulder seams, change the foot back onto a normal foot and do the shoulder seams, and then it's got one of them long lengthy necklines with the collar going towards the back. Now I'm going to have a little bit of a mission. Now I'm going and getting sourcing out some lace for this dress, because it's a beautiful dress that is in a 5-piece anarkali. I will share the result with you inshallah, and show you how I'm gonna go about making the rest of this. Before I go on to do any of the other stitching, I want to just press this and sort of get this finished off. But I assure you that this has been the most easiest of zips to insert, and to be honest, I thought at one point I found this really, really hard, but after trialing it out and practicing, the method has now been perfected, alhamdulillah, and I assure you any one of you will be able to do this. Again, I've used a different color zip, so you can actually tell it's the only color I had available. So that's without being pressed, but that basically is the attachment of the zip. Now, if you were fearful of this sort of like itching you or anything, you can attach a piece of fabric onto this and turn it over so that the inside of this is covered. But it's a quite a comfortable type of a zip, so really it doesn't really make any difference. It's all neatened off, all finished off, and we're going to go on to the next step of actually just hopefully finishing this dress off.